As the adoption of digital courseware continues to spread across a wide range of usage contexts, there's a growing need for a guide to help educators find the tool that best meets their needs. The Courseware in Context, or CWiC framework, which is now entering its third year in development, is a set of evaluation tools intended to help an increasingly broad range of educational stakeholders make informed decisions about selecting and adopting courseware. This is not an easy problem to solve. At the 2017 WCET Annual Conference, we heard from both outgoing and incoming members of CWiC's Advisory Committee about how they are trying to define the scope of the project.
The conversation happens all the time with the Executive Advisory Board about who this tool is really intended to apply to. And it's really 50-50 faculty or centralized, whether that's a learning design team, instructional design group, or some sort of administrator who's doing procurement to bring in the content or the curriculum for a program or even a course. So we're really trying to make the tool usable for an individual faculty member who just wants to do something in their class. However, in the mission is the word scale. So we're really trying to find ways to help more students, more teachers, more programs, rather than just the one-offs. Sometimes that's not how the school works, though. And so we want it to be applicable to that individual faculty member who's just choosing something for their class, and to somebody who's making a programmatic decision of curriculum.
So I think the big question is, when you have a tool like this, how do you scale the tool itself? You know, we talk about scale in terms of courseware, but how do you scale the tool itself to be valued across an institution so that everybody from, you know, even president provost level down to adjunct faculty member understands how it potentially could be a benefit to them? And so for me, that's where I would like to see it go, so that it's not just, oh, this is something that course developers use, or this is for our IT folks, or this is for program directors making, you know, pilot studies happen. But instead, how do we start to try to add value across an institutional structure so that different people could see that it's valuable given different contexts?
The advisory board is thinking about not only the range of possible stakeholders for CWiC, but also how the selection goals and processes change across different educational contexts.
So a couple of things. I think that what I enjoy about the process, and this actually just came to me recently about the courseware piece, is that it's about thinking about the different use cases. So for instance, in one use case, we're using the courseware in context pieces to be able to think about a process. When I'm talking about using it as a process, it's giving me an opportunity to benchmark through the functional capabilities how we're looking at a specific strategy. So for instance, as we're thinking about alternative placement opportunities around mathematics, how are we looking at this collectively as a larger group of stakeholders, right? So math faculty will have one approach, while an administrator or, you know, someone like myself that's running a Center for Innovation may have another approach. And so I think it's really important to really think about how to utilize it in the process of getting to that end goal and really being able to evaluate pieces. I think on the other hand, if you're talking about things like a single small unit of analysis, like a course, it's going to be very different. So in that instance, I think it's really helpful to think about of a control and a treatment. We have one faculty member who's teaching a course with the courseware provider, you know, a digital courseware provider, and the same course without. And in those instances, I can be a lot more clearly in defining control of the variables and, you know, and isolating variables in those instances. And so I think it really needs to be thought of in a larger context than just, you know, one specific use case.
The board members are realistic about the size of the challenge they are taking on and their progress toward achieving the project's ambitions.
I think we're at a very low level consideration of context at this point. If the tool is useful, I think, and if it, you know, as to the extent that it continues, I think that we'll find that the consideration of context will have to become a little more robust, a little more complex. And I think we have scenarios in place where if you're looking, what are the instructional kind of situations you're trying to augment? that direction, I think, will lead to one of the missing pieces, which I'm not sure we'll ever formally incorporate into the tool, but that I think is important, is where is it going to land? What is the situation on your campus in terms of your support, in terms of your experience, in terms of your goals? And I think it's possible to have a courseware initiative, an adaptive courseware type of an initiative, where your goals are modest, where you're looking to improve the understanding of a particular context, a concept. So if you're looking to improve the understanding of a particular concept, then adopting a tool that uses technology to try and help students make their way towards that understanding makes sense. I mean, there are a growing array of tools that are out there. When your expected impact grows, I think there's an equivalent need to kind of consider what's the complexity of expanding your proposed impact.